Good morning, children. Today we will learn about basic ICT skills. ICT stands for Information and Communication Technology. It includes diverse set of technological tools and resources used to communicate, create, store and manage information. It includes the functions of how computers work and how it communicate with the other computers. It deals with the use of electronic media like computer, smartphone, iPad, etc. to store, process and retrieve data or information. ICT stands for Information and Communication Technology. This technology is used to store, communicate, manage information. It includes the functions of computers as well as internet. Various tools which are used for ICT are smartphone, iPad, computer, TV, radio, etc. The role and importance of ICT. First one, pay your bills online, gaining knowledge from website, transfer money between accounts online, order food through smartphone or computer, email circulation in office, book train and flight tickets online, taking online classes, work from home. These are the some functions which are performed by ICT. Pay your bills, gaining knowledge, transfer money between accounts, order food, email circulation, book train and flight tickets, taking online classes, work from home. Now we discuss about various tools which are used for ICT. First one is mobile. Mobiles are the easiest and simplest way of communication. They are very small in size, lightweight and portable. You can touch in with your friends, relatives anytime and anywhere. Students can access the internet on their phones and get information on any topic. Second tool is tab. Tab also a small personal computer with a touch screen. Tablets allow users to input data and instruction through keyboard or mouse. Learning software's app can be downloaded onto the tablets. You also watch videos relevant to your subject. Next tool is radio. It is the oldest tool used to provide entertainment and information to people. This can be used for listening music, radio shows, etc. Then fourth one is TV. TV means television. Tele means distance and vision means seeing. TV means seeing at a distance. It is another important ICT tool which we can watch movies, music shows, programs, etc. The important tool used for ICT is email. Email means electronic mail. It is a common way of communication in today's world. We can send and receive messages through email at very fast. The advantages are, we don't have to pay anything extra for sending or receiving messages. We only need internet connection for sending as well as receiving messages. We can send bulk mail. We can send different types of messages like documents, presentation, images, video, etc. are attached to the email. When you send an email, it reaches the receiver at any part of the world in few seconds. Let us discuss about what is a computer. A computer is an electronic device to enter data, store data and process raw facts and figures according to the given instruction and give the desired result on an output device. Computer is an electronic device which accepts various input, process it after processing, that is produced as an information to the outside world. Here, we discuss about what is date. Data refers to raw facts and figures which do not have any meaning. Data means the input given to the computer which do not have any meaning. But informations are meaningful data or processed data are called as information which are the output produced by the computer. Here, I think you got the differences between data and information. Data are the input given to the computer. Information are the output produced by the computer. Data which do not have any meaning, but information have meaning. Data are the collection of raw facts and figures, but informations are processed data. Then, the basic components of a computer systems are hardwares and softwares. The hardware means the physical parts of the computer system which we can see and touch. You know that a computer consists of so many devices like monitor, printer, CPU, keyboard, mouse. All these devices we can see as well as touch. Such devices are called as hardwares. Then softwares are the programs or applications that run on the computer. Example, MS Word, MS PowerPoint, operating system, etc. I think you got the difference between these two, hardwares and softwares. Hardwares are the physical parts of the computer system which we can see and touch. Softwares are the set of programs or applications that run on the computer. The structure of a computer system is like this. Here, the user give input to through input unit like keyboard, mouse, etc. These input are accepted by the CPU. The CPU process these input, and after processing these data, these processed data are given to the output unit like printers, monitors, etc. These are the three main parts of a computer system: input unit, CPU, and output unit. Input unit which accept data, the CPU process this data, after processing these processed data are given to the output unit. Now we discuss about various devices which are attached to the computer system. First one is called as input devices. These are the devices which are used for entering data or instructions into the computer. Example, keyboard, mouse, touch screen, scanners, webcam. All these are various input devices. These are the devices used for entering data or instructions into the computer. Then second device is processing unit or CPU, central processing unit. This unit is also known as brain of the computer system because all the functions inside the computer systems are controlled and coordinated by CPU, so it is called as brain of computer system. The CPU which performs the following functions: it controls the sequence of operations, it gives commands to the other parts of the computer, and third function, it controls the use of memory for storing data and instruction. These three functions which are performed by CPU: first one, control the sequence of operation; second one, give commands to other parts of the computer; third one, it controls the use of memory for storing data and instruction. A CPU consists of mainly three parts: ALU, CU, and MU. ALU means arithmetic and logic unit, CU means control unit, MU means memory unit. First one, ALU. ALU, arithmetic and logical unit, which perform various arithmetic as well as logic operations. The various arithmetic operations performed by ALU are addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, and exponent. Logical operations performed by CPU are less than, greater than, less than or equal to, greater than or equal to, not equal to. Then second unit of CPU is CU or control unit. This unit controls the flow of data from the input devices to memory and memory to output devices. CU controls the flow of data from input to memory and memory to output devices. Then the last one is registers or memory unit. These are the temporary storage area found in CPU for storing data. The three main parts of CPU are ALU, arithmetic and logic unit, which perform arithmetic as well as logic operation. Second one, CU, which control the flow of data from input to memory and memory to output. Registers, which store data. Then the third device which are attached to the computer systems are output devices. These are the devices which display information to the user, like monitor, printer, speakers, plotters, etc. All these devices are used to display information to the user. Then fourth devices, storage devices. These are the devices which are attached to the computer for storing data, files of operating system and other files. A computer cannot function independently without this installed hard disk drive. These storage devices are again classified into two categories, primary memory and secondary memory. Primary memory are directly accessible by the CPU because CPU take data from primary memory for processing. These primary memory are again divided into two, RAM and ROM. Primary memory are directly accessible by the CPU for processing data. The functions of primary memory are: the data is fed and held until it is ready to be accessed. It holds the result of processing as well as hold the processing instructions. These primary memory are again divided into two categories, RAM as well as ROM. ROM means read-only memory. It is a part of computer's main memory. This is used to store the instructions provided by the manufacturer to check basic hardware and to load operating system. This memory is help to store the instruction provided by the manufacturer to check basic hardware and load operating system from appropriate storage devices. The storage of data and instructions in ROM is permanent until it is written over. The contents of the ROM are not lost, then power supply is switched off. That is why ROM is called the non-volatile memory. ROM is used to store data and instructions provided by the manufacturer to check the basic hardware and helps to load operating system from the appropriate storage devices. The contents in the ROM are not lost when the power supply is switched off. So ROM is called as non-volatile memory. Second category of primary memory is RAM, Random Access Memory. It holds active information of data and information. Information in RAM is accessed in random order. That is why it is known as Random Access Memory. The information in the RAM is accessed in random order, so it is called as Random Access Memory. It is a temporary memory. When power supply is switched off, the information stored in the RAM is lost. So it is also known as volatile or temporary memory. The contents in the RAM will be erased when the power supply is switched off. So it is known as volatile memory. It is also known as read or write memory, as information can be read from RAM and also written onto it. Information stored in RAM may be erased or written over when the computer is on. I think you got the difference between RAM and ROM. RAM means random access memory. ROM means read-only memory. RAM data can be read or write, but in ROM only read from it. RAM are volatile memory, ROM are non-volatile memory. Volatile means when the power supply is switched off, the contents in the memory will be erased. Such memories are called as volatile. When the contents are retained, such memories are called as non-volatile memory. Then the second category of memory is secondary memory. Secondary memory is used to store bulk of information. The information stored in the secondary memory is not lost even when computer is switched off. It is known as non-volatile memory. Secondary storage devices include hard disk, CD, DVD.